Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about Oracle Database SP file and P file. So what is the initialization parameter file, SP file and P file? So in Oracle there are two kinds of initialization parameter file. One is the SP file and second one is a P file. So when you start the instance, when you start the Oracle Database instance, the initialization parameter file is read first. First of all, Oracle reads the initialization parameter file. So there are two types of initialization parameter files. One is a SP file, one is a P file. Server parameter file, text initialization parameter file. And the location of the file on the DBS server is Oracle Home DBS. Under this location, these two files are available. What is the difference between these two files, SP file and P file? Server parameter file, SP file, is a preferred type of initialization parameter file. Oracle, when you start the instance, Oracle first read server parameter file. If this file is not available, then it will read the P file. Initially, Oracle will read the SP file. If this file is not available, then Oracle will read the P file. It's a binary file. SP file is a binary file, can be written to and read by the Oracle DB server. This is not a text-based file. So Oracle can only write any changes if you are doing in this file, that can be only be done by the Oracle DB server only, not manually. It resides on the server. This is always available on the server. Next, it is persistent across the shutdown and startup. When you start up the database and shut down the database, it is a persistent. And the default name of your SP file is SP file and your SID name, SID.ORA. Next is a text initialization parameter file. So text file read by DB server but can't return by the DB server. If you want to do the any kind of changes in the parameter file, in the P file parameter file, so you need to do it by manually. You can't do using the Oracle commands. Fine, ultra session command you can't use over here. Here you need to just edit it by using the VI editor or any of the text editor, in case if you want to do the any kind of changes in the P file. Can be reside on the server as well as on the client machine. It can be on the server or it can be on the client machine, but in the SP file it is always on the server. Default name of the P file is init and sid.ora. init sid.ora. So this is your SID name. Next, initialization parameter. Few parameters are there in Oracle: control file, DB file, processes, DB block size, SDA targets, memory target, and undo management. So here the first parameter called control files. In this parameter, you can define how many control files you have in Oracle database, like 2 control files, 3 control files. DB files, in this parameter, you can just define the how many number of database files you have. Next one is a processes, maximum number of OS users, processes that can simulate correctly. So this parameter is also there, that here you can define maximum number of OS user processes that can simulate correctly. So how many OS users processes can use this, that define you can under this processes parameter. Next is a DB block size. In this parameter you need to define what is the your database block size, 8 KB, 16 KB, 32 KB, that you need to define under this. SDA target, here you need to define the size of the SDA in this parameter. Memory target, here this is the total memory used by the Oracle, that you can define under this parameter called memory underscore target. Undo management, so if you want to define the undo management, whether it is auto or manual, that you can define under this parameter called undo management. Next, initialization parameter, changing the initialization parameter values. So if you want to change the any parameter value, so how can you change it? So there are two kinds of parameters are there. One is a static parameter, one is a dynamic parameter. Few parameters are statics in Oracle, few parameters are dynamic. So what is the differences between these two, static parameter and dynamic parameter? So this parameter can only be changed in the parameter file. This parameter can only be changed in the parameter file. Require restarting the instance before taking the effect. This is the very important thing. If any parameter is static, and if you are changing the value of that parameter, for that you need to restart to affect that value. You need to restart the Oracle database to affect that value. Next parameter is dynamic parameter. So can be changed while the database is online. When your database is up and running, on that time, if you want to change the value of dynamic parameter, you can just change it. If you want to change the processes from 80 to 100, then you can change it online. You no need to shut down your database and you no need to start up your database. But in the static parameter, which is very important, that you need to shut down and start up the database. Next is a can be altered at session level or at the system level. Dynamic parameter can be altered, can be session level or the system level. Are valid for the duration session based on the scope setting. Whatever the scope setting you have defined, according to that, it will be valid. Next is are changed by using the command called alter session or alter system command. So if you want to change the value of any dynamic parameter, you can use the alter session command or alter system command. These two commands are there. Using these two commands, you can just change the value for the initialization parameters. Fine. Next is how to create SP file from P file and P file from SP file. So here you can see this is the SQL commands we have. If you want to, if you have already the SP file is available, and if you want to change the, if you want to create the P file from SP file, this is the command you have, create P file. This is the location of the P file where you want to create from SP file. So here, after that, once you create this P file, you can change the value of all the parameter under the P file, and you can just start your database with the P file. If you want to change the multiple parameter at the same time, fine. And if you don't, you don't want to write down the each and every time alter session command, alter session command, what you can do, you can just create the one P file from SP file, change all the parameter, start up your database with the P file. Next, in case if you want to create SP file from your P file, you can use this command, create SP file from P file. This is the P file. You can just create SP file from P file using this command. Fine. So if you want to create P file from SP file, SP file to P file, you can just create very easily. This is a simple SQL command. Database is running with the SP file or P file. So if you want to check whether your database is running with the SP file or P file, so if you want to check this, you can use the below command, show parameter SP file. Once you execute this command, show parameter SP file, if it is returning some value, this parameter, that means your database is running with the SP file. Or if it is not returning any of the value, that means your database is running with the P file. Fine. So in this session, we have discussed about the Oracle SP file, P file, dynamic parameter, static parameter, some initialization parameter, and how to create SP file and P file. Next, we are going to see the practical session for how to change the value for the parameters and how to create SP file from P file and P file from the SP file. Let's discuss about how to create SP file from P file and P file from SP file. So first of all, let's connect to the SQL plus. So first of all, just set up the export Oracle SID that is equal to ORCL because our database name is ORCL. Next, just connect to the SQL plus with the sys as a sysdb authentication. Just provide the password. So here you can see you are just connected to Oracle Database 11g Enterprise Edition database. Here the first you can just see the your name and open mode for your database. So here it is a ORCL and read write mode. Next, first thing is just check the location of your SP file. So here you can see the location of your SP file is Oracle Home DBS. So first of all, let's see the location of where the file is available, our SP file. So the default location, whenever you are just creating the database using the DBCA, on that time, your database is, whenever you are creating your database with the DBCA, your file is available at DBS location, Oracle Home DBS location. So let's see CD Oracle Home DBS. So here you can see this is the file is there. SP file, and this is the your instance name overseer.ora. This is the your SP file. By default is created whenever you are just creating the database with the DBCA. This is the binary file, so you can't edit it directly. You can't open it in the VI editor and you can't edit it. Fine. Next, just come to the SQL prompt window. So just issue the command SQL plus sys as a sysdba ORCL. Fine. And now next, see how to create P file from SP file and SP file from P file. So let's see. So here
we have a commands for this. You can see the command how to create sp file from sp file and sp file from p file. So create p file, you can just create the p file at whatever the location you want to create. I have just created the p file at location u01 p file.org from sp file. This file is binary, this file is text file. So if you want to do the any kind of changes in the parameter, you can do it from the p file directly. And if you want to do the any kind of changes into the sp file, you need to issue the command from the sql prompt using the alter system set command. Fine. So this kind of changes that you need to in the p file and sp file you can just perform. Fine. Like if you want to do the any kind of changes, you can perform in the sp file directly. So let's see. First of all, create p file. u01 pfile.ora from sp file. Fine. So here we are just creating the file. This is the binary file, this is the text based file. So here you can see the file is created. Now just come to this. Fine. Here you can see the file pfile.ora file, and you can just open it with the pfile.ora. Fine. So this is the all your parameters which is available in sp file. Now it is available in the p file which we have created. So here you can see the all the list of parameters. Fine. These are the all the your parameters. Fine. Your audit file, these are the all your memory parameters, db cache size, java pool size. This is the your file destination, audit trail, compatibility, control files, db block size, db domain, db name, db file, recovery file destination, then the memory target, open cursor. These are the your parameters. Fine. So at this moment we are not going to change any kind of parameters. So I am just saving these files and just execute. So this is the first way that you can just create the p file from sp file. Next we are going to see like how to create how to create the sp file from p file. Fine. So let's see, just connected to the sql plus prompt. Sys as a sysdba. Fine. And just create sp file from p file. Here if you are not defining location for the sp file at the default location, at dbs location, it is going to be just created. So here cannot create sp file already being used by the instance. So at this moment your sp file is being used by this instance, so you can't create it. If you want to create it at some other location, you can just create. So let's see. Fine. So at the default location, it is not going to be created because it is in use. But if you want to just create it at some other location, you can also create it at some other location. But Oracle by default use this location. Fine. Oracle Home DBS. This is the file is created. So in future, if you want to use this SP file, you can use this SP file. Fine. Next is, if you want to check whether my database is running on SP file or P file. See, database can run either on SP file or on P file, not on both. So if you want to check whether the database is running with the SP file or p file, how can you check? The simple command, show parameter sp file. So here you can see if it is running, if it is returning the value, fine, that means your database is running with the your sp file. Database is running with the sp file. Fine. If it is not returning any value here, if you are receiving the null, that means your database is running with the file. So at this moment your database is running with the your database is running with the your sp file. Fine. So just check the command, show parameter sp file, whether the database is running with the sp file or p file. Next is how to start database with p file. See, database by default starting with sp file. Oracle will first check the sp file. If it is at Oracle Home DBS location, if it is find the SP file, then it will start the database with your SP file. If it is not find, then Oracle will search for the P file. So in case in future, if you want to start your database with your P file, you can also start with the P file. So let's see how to start database with the P file. So here we have a P file available at U01. You can see this is the P file dot ORA file, P file dot ORA file. Fine. Using this file, you can just start your database. So first of all, I need to shut down my database. So let's shut down. Fine, connected to the ideal instance. Now start up database with the P file. Fine, so here you can see the database is started with the P file. Fine, and once it started, just check the parameter, show parameter SP file. You can see the value is null. That means your database is running with the P file, not with the SV file. Fine. So here next is how to edit the parameters in P file and the SP file. So P file parameter editing is very easy. Fine. So here I am just showing to you. Let me just exit CD U01 VI P file dot ORA. Fine. So here if you want to do any kind of changes in the parameter file, you can directly just change. Fine. So here you can just change this parameter. There is a 200 processes open cursor. You can just increase to 500. Fine. If you want to change any other parameter, you can also change. So at this moment, I'm just changing these two parameters and I'm just saving the file. So once I'm saving the file, fine. And if you want to apply these changes, you need to shut down your database and start up your database because your database is running with the P file. So if you want to apply these changes, you need to shut down. A shutdown is required. Fine. And after that, you need to just start up your database. So let me just connect it to the SQL plus sys as a sysdba orcl shutdown immediate. Fine. Start up with the P file. Fine. U01 P file dot ORA. So here, once it is started, you can just check the parameters. How to check parameter? Let's see. Show parameter processes. Fine. So here, this is the our processes that I have changed the value, that is 200. You can see. So let me just show you the exact. That is the 200. Fine. So this is the your processes parameter, that is the we have just changed the value, that is the 200. Next is open cursor show parameter. You can directly check it from the here. Fine. That is the I have changed the value 500. So in the P file editing is very easy. Just open the P file, change the value and just start up, shut down and start up the database. But here the if the production database is there, then you can't shut down your database and you can't start up the database because it's a production database. So on that time, your database should be running with the SP file, and if any kind of parameter changes you require using the alter system command, you can just change. So let's see this thing practically. So let me just shut down the database. I'm going to start my database with the SP file. So if I'm issuing that by default command startup, it will just start with the SP file. Fine. So what I will do now, next, I will just check show parameter SP file. You can see value is returning. That means your database is running with the SP file. Now I will just change the parameter show parameter. That is the 150. Why it is 150? Because in the SP file, the value is 150. But in the P file, I have changed the value, that is the 200. Fine. But here in the SP file, my value is Here this is the SP file 200, SP file 150. So here I need to change this to the 200. So how can I change in the SP file? Using the ultra system set command. So here ultra system set processes 200. Fine. You need to just define the scope. Three kind of values you can define in the scope. That is, the one is the SP file, one is a memory, one is a both. So first is SP file means whenever you shut down your database and whenever you next time start up your database, on that time this is going to be applied. This changes is going to be applied. If you are doing writing memory, so that is going to be directly applied to immediately. It will change the value from 150 to 200. And if you are defining both, that means it will just change to the immediate memory, and whenever you next time start up, on that time it is also going to be changed value from 150 to 200. So here I am just defining at this moment, that is SP file. Fine, system ultra. So here you can see the parameter, show parameter processes 150. It is not changed. But whenever you next time shut down database and whenever you next time start up, on that time this changes is already been applied. Fine. So if you are defining scope equal to SP file, that means whenever you shut down and start up, on that time it is going to be applied. Otherwise it is not going to be applied. So let it be start. So show parameter. Fine, this change. Now ultra system set processes equal to 250. But scope equal to I am defining memory. Fine. Yeah. This parameter you can't change immediately. So if you want to just directly to the memory, you can't change it. So here we can just take the parameter set open underscore cursors. That is, you can just change to the show parameter, because few parameters you can't change directly to the memory, that you can only change with the SP file value, scope equal to SP file. So but here if I am just taking open cursors, that is the 300, I am just changing the value. So I am just showing you ultra system set open underscore cursor equal to 500, scope equal to memory, system alter. This parameter you can change directly to the memory, so it is going to be applied immediately. Show parameter open underscore cursors 500. Same way you can just change the value ₹600, scope equal to both. So this is going to be applied immediately, as well as it is going to be applied next time when you start up the database, that is going to be applied into the SP file also. Fine. So in this way you can just change the value of parameters. So here we have discussed about how to create P file from SP file, SP file from P file. Fine. We have also seen the things like how to change the value into P file and how to start up the database with the P file. Also we have discussed about how to alter the how to change the value in SP file using ultra system set command, including the scope. Fine, thank you.